this is a superworm, which is what this video is all about. Yeah. So this is basically a very common feed for the monster fishes like arowanas and all of that. So basically you need to feed them also, because this is a good food for your monster fishes. So to take care of these guys, and they are healthy. If they are healthy, if this is what you are feeding your fish, these guys also need to be healthy. So you need to house them in a nice way. So what I'm going to be showing you here is how to keep them well and healthy, so your fishes are also healthy. Yeah. Shallow. So for this, mainly you can keep them in a box container like this. So this basically is first let me put this one back into the mug. Yeah. So this basically is a plastic box. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be making holes, leaving about 1.5 inches of without holes. On top I'm going to make a lot of holes, and then fill this up with wheat barn. This is what it's called. It's something like oats what we get. You can even use, if you don't find this, you can also use plain non-flavored oats. You get it in different brands also, so you can use that. So this will get into this as a full bed, and you need to give ventilation so there's no moisture formation, and then put all your superworms into this. Yep. So let me make the holes in this and get back. So made all holes for ventilation. Yeah. So now let's fill this up. So this wheat bran is something these guys feed on. Should also once in a while give them some vegetables like carrot. You can also give beetroot. It seems they like apple, so I'm going to be trying that also. So firstly I just want to make their new home first, and then try out all kinds of food for them. Yeah, have about 100 of them which I picked up from microworms.in. So as you can see, there's a pretty decent layer of the wheat bran. So now let's put this big fellow inside, and a lot more are there which are waiting to go to their new home. Quite a few of them. Yeah. I don't like catching them with their hand, with the hands. So it's a little too creepy for me. Yeah. As you can see how they're going inside, as soon as they get their get into the new home. So I heard beetroot is really something they like, and carrot is something they really like. So I'll be dropping off a piece of carrot, and we'll see after a day or two what happens to it. Okay, let me add all of them and then get back. So transferred almost 100 of them into this. All of them have gone inside. Anyways, so this is two pieces of beetroot which I've cut. You shouldn't overfeed them, because what happens when you overfeed, see, every vegetable has got some amount of moisture, so that will make this entire wheat bran and all little damp. So it shouldn't be too much. So I'm just putting two pieces because there are close to 100 of them. So one is here, this is beetroot. So I just let them be, and let's see what happens to this in a day or two. Okay, so let's close it and see what happens to the beetroot after a day. Yay! So previously you guys saw we added some beetroot, and I don't see the beetroot at all. It is being consumed. Okay, there's a little bit of it. You can see what has happened to the beetroot. Yeah, there should be another piece somewhere. Yeah, so this is what is left. So you can see they have consumed it pretty well. You should not let this to create, so that's why you should not add too much. If you add too much of vegetables, the moisture what forms from the vegetables is too much. So yeah, there is still life in this left, so these guys will feed on it. Yeah, so this is some of the ways to take care of these guys. There are about close to 100 of them inside this. Yeah, and the wheat barn, you should leave it when it becomes kind of little very powdery. Yeah, this is all fine now. Yeah, so these guys will definitely come and start chewing up all of the vegetables. So weekly once you can add two pieces of any vegetable like beetroot, carrot, potato. So just like two small pieces, and they will feed on it. So this is all it is. So need a box. You need some. If you don't get this wheat bran, you can use, like I said earlier, the normal oats. And you need some ventilation. That's about it. Yo, this is done. That is. So this is her food. She knows it's her dabba, and she's just waiting, like, why are we not feeding her? Yeah, coming, I'll feed you. Okay, so this is what is left over of the beetroot. So what I did was I had actually just cut the beetroot and I had not removed the outer side layer, the skin, so they didn't eat it. So you need to remove the skin and then feed it to your super worms. Yeah, so this is all is left of the beetroot. Yep, so weekly once, beetroot, carrot or potato. Yeah, you can feed. I heard even they like apples, so maybe remove the skin and then feed the apples, be good. Yeah, she just loves them. So you can use a small plate and keep carrot or any vegetables what you want to keep. They will find it and they will definitely eat, because if you saw previously the beetroot what I put, it actually, the because the moisture, you know, the wheat bran kind of gets very soggy. So it's better to keep a plate and like this and keep your vegetables, and so it's easy to clean it out also. They actually come and started eating. Now I opened the box, I think they got scared. Otherwise, yeah, this is just a suggestion from what I showed previously.
If you like the video, please do give it a like. If you didn't like the video, do drop in your comments why you didn't like the video. And if you have not subscribed to the channel, do subscribe. We make very interesting topics like this.